हाय, गुड मॉर्निंग. कसे आहेत सगळे? आई वॉज प्लॅनिंग टू स्टार्ट द सेशन बाय रीडिंग आउट ऑल द मेसेजेस अँड कमेंट्स आय एम गेटिंग, अँड आय वॉन्टेड टू थँक एव्हरी वन पर्सनली. पण आज जुम्मा है आणि आमच्याकडे लाईट जाणार आहेत, सो वी हॅव टू फिनिश द सेशन बाय 10:30. सो आय एम नॉट गोइंग टू वेस्ट एनी टाईम टुडे. आय एम डिरेक्टली जम्प इन टू अ वर्कआउट. लेट्स स्टार्ट. Awesome. Everyone get ready. Get your mat. We are going to start with. Start in sideline position. Get into starting position of clamshells. Engage your core. Let's do 10 repetitions. Today we are going to do 8 exercises back to back. Every exercise 10 repetitions. 3, 4, 5. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and other side. Engage your core, tighten your abs, keep them tight throughout. Let's go. 1, 2, 3, 4. Don't lose your abs. Keep them in control so that you don't end up using your lower back. Let's do last 4. 3. Wonderful. Let's go into glute bridges. For everyone, we are going to do first 10 repetitions on both legs, then we will switch to single leg. Tighten your core, check your lower back. Lower back should be in contact with the ground. Tighten your core, squeeze your glutes and lift yourself up. Three, four. Every single time, try to squeeze your glutes as much as possible. 6, hips hard like apples, not squishy like applesauce. Last 4. 5. Excellent. Let's go on one leg. For whom this is more comfortable, stay here. If you want more challenge, let's go. Keep your hand leg straight in air. Let's do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Switch sides. 1, 2, 3, keep your toe pointed, leg straight. 4, 5, great job. This is a new exercise today. It's called dead bug. So the back will remain in the neutral position as we always keep it. Engage your core. I'm lifting both my legs. I'm pointing my knees towards the ceiling. I'm also going to extend my arms up and point my fingers towards ceiling. This is our starting position. From this position, you will take opposite hand and leg back. When I'm taking my hand and leg back, I am still engaging my core. I'm not letting my abs lose control. The more down you go, more challenging it will be. So whatever your range is, stick to that range. If you can go only this much without bending your back, you stick here. For people who can go all the way back, let's go all the way back. Other side. Continue. It's important when you're taking your opposite hand and leg back, this hand should remain pointing towards the ceiling and this knee should remain. Because a lot of times people lose control. This is an exercise for your core as well as your coordination. Now, without stopping, let's finish 8 counts. Abs tight. Breathe in as you go down. Breathe out as you crunch. I am not touching my hand and leg to the ground. It is totally controlled by my muscles. I'm resisting gravity. I'm just taking my hand and leg as close to ground so that the pull from the gravity is maximum. Last two on each side. Hang in there. Beautiful. Turn around, get into dog position. We are going to hold dog position for 10 seconds. Now when you're holding, make sure your form is perfect. Tuck your chin, shoulder blades in back pocket, tuck your abs. Your hands and your legs should be perpendicular to your torso. 1 in 1,000, 2 in 1,000, 3 in 1,000, 4 in 1,000, 5 in 1,000, 6 in 1,000, 7 in 1,000, 8 in 1,000, 9 in 1,000, 10 in 1,000. Let's go to bird dog, 5 on each side. Slow and steady and with lot of control. Keep your toes pointed. 3 more on each side. Abs tight. Wonderful. Let's move to shoulder taps. You can either do it from dog position or you can walk your hands forward, open your hips, get into starting position of knee push up and do the taps from this position. Anything that you can perform with perfect form. I'm going to start here, then I will move to full plank. Tap with control. So when you're lifting your hand, I don't want you to lose control of your spine. Keep spine aligned. Let's go to high plank if possible. Let's tap. 3 more on each side. Body weight constantly forward, core engaged, hips tight. Let's do one bonus. Excellent job. Go into the ground, stomach on the ground, forehead on the ground, hands straight up, palms facing each other, thumbs pointing towards the ceiling. Let's do 10 counts of IY, TWO. Slow and control, don't rush the movement. Remember that when you're in T, still your thumb is the ceiling. W, O. Core engaged, I, Y, T, W, O. Bring your shoulder blades together. I, Y, T, W, O. I'm only going to count the repetitions. Four. Hands off the ground throughout the motion. You will feel the burn around your shoulder blades as well as in your arms. Don't give up. Hang in there. Last 4 reps. Three to go. Last 2, go with my tempo. I, hold there. Y, hold your Y position. Let's go to T and hold. You are doing good. Stay focused, stay committed. W. O. One last. I. Y. T. W. Hold W. O. Excellent job, everyone. Get up. A new exercise today called star balance exercise. You are going to stand on one leg. So for people who are finding standing on one leg itself little difficult, you will just stand on one leg and try to hold this position. You can also stand close to the wall so that you start losing balance. You can hold the wall and prevent the fall. Okay? Always when you are doing anything related to balance, first ensure you are safe. Okay? Okay, for others, keep your hands on the hips, get on one leg. So imagine there is a star drawn with four lines. So you have 8 points and we are going to try and touch every single point with our toes. When I say touch, it's a very gentle touch like this. I don't want this to happen. Okay, if you're putting entire weight forward, it means you're losing balance. This is challenge for this leg. Okay, let's go. First, point your toes like a ballerina. Create that arch in your foot from this position. The idea is to go as far out and touch, but you can start conservatively. So, if you are finding this standing position itself difficult, first just go slow or do it with less distance. So, I will show one repetition with minimum distance. So this is my first point, 45 degrees apart. There is second point, then the side, again in between, back, this side. This is also, this is difficult. So that's why I'm asking you to go conservative. One star is complete. Let's do it on other leg. Next repetition, I'm going to challenge myself. If you are feeling confident, you can try it too, but be cautious, okay? Don't be overconfident. Only touching and coming back. Good. Nice. My foot is on fire. Awesome. Other side. Point your toe. Let's start on top. 45 degrees out. Side. All the way back, other corner, side. See, now I'm losing balance. Let's go all the way out, as much out as possible. Excellent job. Last thing, we are going to go into deep squat. So if deep squat is difficult, just go back, use the wall. As low as you can go and hold this position. We are going to hold the position for 10 seconds. 1 in 1,000, 2 in 1,000, 3 in 1,000, 4 in 1,000, 5 in 1,000, 6 in 1,000, 7 in 1,000, 8 in 1,000, 9 in 1,000, 10 in 1,000. As I always tell you, from deep squat, if you're not used to, first go down on the ground. We don't want any sudden change in the blood pressure. From this position, you can check if you can still sit cross-legged like this. or you are going to practice it every day. If you cannot, let's sit in either cross-legged position or Padmasana, whatever is comfortable. Half Padmasana is also okay. Let's do deep breathing, 5 counts. I'm going to count 5 in my head and breathe in. And I'm going to do a longer breathe out with 10 counts, okay? Breathe in always through your nose, breathe out through your mouth like you're blowing a candle. Nice. Now we have relaxed ourselves. Let's do the stretches. Starting with fetal position, we are going to hold every stretch for 10 seconds. Get into 90-90 position. Let's go for pigeon. Other side, first 90-90, pigeon, beautiful. Get into side lying position, fold your knee forward, let's open the book, hold for 10. Other side. Please put your shoulder blades in back pocket. There is a looking pocket stretch. Other side. Wonderful. Now find a wall. Let's do forward lunge. Sink slowly in any stretch. Don't try to push yourself too much. If you are restricted here, just hold here for 5 seconds, then try to go down. You will not let your torso fall forward. Keep your torso upright. Hold the stretch for 10 seconds. Excellent. Other side. Push your knee forward. Beautiful. Last one, calf stretch on the wall. I will do it here. Toe on the wall, heel on the ground, both knees straight. Sink on the wall. Feel the stretch at the back of your calf. Try to go and touch your forehead on the wall. Wonderful. Let's do one last. Knee straight. Beautiful. And done. See, this routine did not take anything more than 15 minutes. So specifically, I included this routine so that you never ever have to face the problem that I don't have time to do workout. Okay. Plus, the beauty of this workout is you can, I told you, modifications every single time. So you can make the same exercise more intense or less intense. For example, shoulder tap. The moment you are in high plank, just doing 5 controlled taps can kill you. It is going to depend on your form. If you are just staying loose and you're not really focusing on keeping your abs and glutes engaged, then obviously it will not be effective. But I always tell you, form is everything. Plus, now this is a circuit. So if you have more time or if you want something more intense, you can repeat this circuit again and again. You can do 3 to 4 rounds. So you will do full circuit, then again take maybe half a minute break and repeat the whole circuit. Third way of increasing or decreasing the intensity is, we did 10 counts today. You can go up till 20 counts on each exercise. Okay, so depending upon how much time you have and what your level is, you can modify this. So please share this with every single person who you think will be benefited from it.